Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So as you can see, I've revived the old vacuum chamber, and I'm doing an experiment today that I've been wanting to do for a very long time. So I've got a magnet on that cup there, which is being levitated. There's a block of bismuth, and between the bismuth and another magnet I've got up here, it is being held in position. The little magnet is repelling the bismuth and being attracted to this, as well as being pulled down by gravity, and all forces are balanced. And in fact, one way that I've used to balance this is the top of this metal box here, which is stainless steel, by the way, it's not magnetic, is a little bit springy, and so if I add a little bit of weight to the magnet, I can make the magnet a little bit closer and make the magnet feel stronger, and thus make this little guy here levitate more. See, when I add weight to it, the magnet down there begins to float higher. In fact, when I fire this up and pull a vacuum, which I do intend to do, I'll probably take the weight off initially and then add weight to it to get it to balance without, that way I don't have to take into account the weight of the air that it's displacing initially. So yes, this is a video that I said I'd do quite a while ago.
I should try evacuating all the air out of the jar.
I'm finally getting around to it. The question is, will that little thing spin forever if I remove air resistance? See, most forms of friction here are already removed. If I reach in and give it a little bit of a bump, then it'll start spinning. And it'll sit there and spin for quite a while, but it does eventually stop. Only after a few minutes, really. And the question is it air resistance that's stopping it? Well, let's remove the air and find out. Now, you might have noticed the little glass tube, which was causing me to actually have trouble spinning it there. Now, this is actually what I'm going to be using to spin it up under vacuum, because I can't touch it in any way if the vacuum chamber is around here, and there's no air or anything. So what I've got is a little piece of wood in there, which I'll heat up with my laser. It'll produce gas, and the gas will blow out through this tube. It's not very much gas, but it should be enough to give the magnet a little bit of a nudge, and then the gas will be evacuated by my vacuum pump. Okay, so as you can see, we're down to a pretty decent vacuum, around a millimeter of mercury, so almost all the air has been removed. And I've got the magnet so it's floating. Now we're going to heat up the wood and see if we can propel it and make it spin. Let me actually move over to the other side here. I'm going to heat up the wood in 3, 2, 1. Any reaction? Perhaps it's not strong enough. Only got a mild twisting effect there, I think. Okay, let's turn this pump off so we can actually hear ourselves think. Or rather, hear the bees buzzing around the light. Let's refocus the camera here. Let's see, yeah, the vacuum is holding. I think I've got most of the leaks gone. So, I think one thing I could do is actually move the magnet up top. See, when I move it a little bit, the magnet down below moves with it. Now, if I rotate the big magnet, it's not gonna start the little one spinning. So, rotating this magnet here won't actually do anything, because the magnetic field is coming straight out of the magnet. Rotating it does not change the orientation of that field. What I'm doing to move that magnet down in there is just kind of moving the entire magnet a little bit like this. But I can move it around and bump it into that piece of glass. There we go. Let's just kind of nick it on there and get it spinning. It's not as easy as it looks. There we go. Now it's going. Freely spinning magnet inside of a vacuum chamber. Excellent. Let's just see how long it goes. Doesn't look like it's touching anywhere, so I think we're good. In fact, if I move the camera a little bit down, you should be able to see right underneath of it. Yeah, see that? It does appear to be slowing down though. So that tells me that air resistance is not the main thing that's causing a magnet to stop eventually. It might be spinning a little bit longer, but it's not significant. I think it's just going to slow right to a stop. Sort of makes sense though, especially if you've ever studied Faraday discs. The rotating magnet there is essentially a little Faraday disc. It takes energy to rotate a conductor inside of a magnetic field, and what better conductor than a chunk of metal that is magnetized. And it looks like it's just about stopping. It's got a little bit of a tilt one direction. I think that's mostly due to the fact that the magnet isn't perfect. It'd be pretty hard to make it perfect, in fact. Just a slight variation of the magnetic field off to one side will cause it to tip like that. Like maybe the magnet got hit at some point during its processing. There you go. So it's kind of favoring one direction over the other. Also, it'll be causing some eddy currents in the metal. You know, if you've ever seen those plumb bombs that are dampened using a magnet, it's using the eddy current effect from moving magnetic field over the metal to create a breaking effect. I possibly could use something that's non-conductive, like maybe a salt of bismuth. That might work, or even water. The levitating gap would be much smaller in that case. No, I couldn't use water because this is a vacuum. There you go. It will not spin forever. It might spin a little bit longer, but it won't sit there and spin forever. It is theoretically possible to make something that'll spin forever, but you'd have to have something that is non-conductive of electricity, and I don't know of any magnetic materials that fit that property. There you go. Hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you next time.